legs for the duration of 3 months. She's basically a businesswoman. She travels a lot and she has severe back pain that radiates down the leg. Now, in such a scenario, the options that she had, what happened was this back pain was so severe that it was restricting her activities and she was not able to walk properly. So this led to her gaining more weight, and this weight put more strain on her back, and ultimately it became a vicious cycle wherein the back pain was causing her to gain weight and this weight gain was putting more strain on her back. Now initially she was supposed to undergo therapy, treatment or open surgery in UK. She was supposed to go there. One of her relatives had undergone treatment in our clinic before, so she had, the other person had recommended, and so she came to our clinic. Now the options before her, somebody, her weight when she came to us was about 132 kgs, which is on the higher side, and she had a few comorbid conditions and her pain was quite severe. Now the options before her are she can undergo open surgery, or she can tolerate pain and carry on with life with just conservative therapy. Now open surgery for a patient of this weight would carry a significant amount of complications. One, there are complications in the surgery itself. Second, there are complications in giving general anesthesia. Third, there are complications in the recovery period, or ventilation. The patient has to lie down, face down. It requires a much bigger operation theater table, and the recovery period is longer, and so on and so forth. Multiple complications, post-surgery, she has to go to an ICU, and all these complications were in front of us. So we decided to do a minimally invasive procedure, something that we call like a keyhole surgery. Now keyhole surgery is something that has come up newly for procedures related to the back. Keyhole surgery is one where whatever surgery or surgical approach is supposed to be done is done through a small hole in the back. Now the hole that we are talking about is about 1 to 2 millimeters long, and through this hole we go inside and do whatever procedure that needs to be done. Now the basic problem that was causing her back pain was she had what we call as a disc prolapse. The disc is something that is like a shock absorber between the vertebral bones. Now these bones, because of wear and tear, because of weight or because of falls, sometimes these discs can bulge out. When this disc bulges out, it compresses on the nerve root that comes down the leg. That's what causes the pain. So we did a procedure called a percutaneous discectomy. Percutaneous discectomy is, percutaneous means going through the skin, and discectomy is removal of the disc. So before that we had to evaluate this patient, so we had ordered for an MRI scan. Normally if somebody requires an MRI scan, we send to any MRI center and the scan is done. Because she was on the bigger side, she wouldn't go into the MRI machine itself. So we had to get a special MRI scan wherein it's called an open MRI scan, and the space through which the patient goes inside is much bigger, and then we got a scan for her, and then we did this procedure called percutaneous discectomy. Percutaneous discectomy is you go in through a 1 millimeter hole and then you go inside, remove the disc, and all this is visualized by a visible X-ray machine, and then it's a technical procedure wherein the part of the disc is taken out through a small hole. Now the obvious advantage with doing a percutaneous discectomy is it's not an open surgery. So you don't have to undergo general anesthesia. It can be done under IV sedation or local anesthesia. In her case, we gave IV sedation. And one, the procedure is done in about 30 minutes. A normal procedure, open surgery will take about 1 to 2 hours. And the anesthesia complications are reduced. And once the procedure is over, the patient can go home on the same day. Now going home on the same day is obviously a day care surgery, and this has got multiple benefits for a heavy patient like her, because you avoid all the risk of hospital stay like infection, thrombosis and so on and so forth. One, and second is you are able to mobilize this patient much faster, so that helps in her rehabilitation. This patient came to us last week. She underwent the procedure on Thursday afternoon around the same time, and 2 days later, from Thursday to Saturday, here she is sitting in a beautiful dress clothes, beautiful clothes, in front of a press conference. So 2 days, she is completely recovered. Right now she is undergoing physiotherapy to further strengthen her muscles, and we also start her exercises for her further weight reduction. So that's how fast this procedure works. So she came to us, I saw her on last Saturday. The MRI scan was done on Monday. Thursday she underwent the procedure under IV sedation. Thursday evening this patient went home, and Saturday she is here. Her back pain is gone now. This is Mr. Shibal. Shibal is her brother. Now, while coming in the car, Shibal was telling me that yesterday she walked about 1 kilometer without pain. So because of a procedure which we do through a small incision, we are able to avoid the complications of major surgery, and we avoid excellent results without undergoing major surgery. So the message that I would like to tell to the press is, all pains can be relieved. It could be anything related to the back or headache or the joints. It could be because of orthopedic region, neurological region, or because of cancer. All these pains can be treated. We have dedicated centers where only pain is handled. We have a multidisciplinary team where you have pain specialists, you have orthopedician, you have neurologists in the same center, where all these can be tackled. And without undergoing surgery, you can tackle a lot of problems. And treating pain is a fundamental right now. So earlier, at least in India, we were thinking a lot of pains cannot be cured, and we were silently tolerating the pain. That will have to change. Pain clinics are widespread in the West, in the US and UK. Multiple pain centers are available. They are just coming to India, and the main thing that we require is awareness among the people that there is a specialty like this, and there are pain clinics in Chennai, and they do treat patients who have pain, and they can undergo treatment and complete cure without undergoing open surgery. That would be my message for this event. So thank you, and if you have any clarification about the procedure that we did, I will answer it. If you have any direct questions to the patient, we will answer it. She doesn't speak English. Mr. Shibal will help you. And if you have any questions regarding pain clinics in general, I will be happy to answer them. No. What we are trying to do here is we go and precisely take out whatever material is protruding and come out. So the side effects are significantly less when compared to general anesthesia. There are no side effects. At this, see, there are multiple level disc prolapses. This is Dr. Ravikrishna. He's my, he's a senior consultant. He's my senior colleague in the clinic. We both work together. The procedure is done. It's not done blind. We have an X-ray machine. We know what is the part that is protruding. So through this keyhole, through an X-ray machine, the X-ray machine is monitoring us all the time. It's a moving X-ray machine. And then we go in and identify which is protruding, and then we take out that material and come out. So very unlikely the same place that we corrected this problem will recur again. Very unlikely. There is a small possibility if she doesn't reduce her weight, and if she continues, and if she were to travel, or if she takes a weight, the part that is above or below it, there is a small possibility that can protrude, but that is the case with anything.
Is it only because of the weight?
No, it is not only because of the weight. The weight contributed to it. It could have been, usually somebody has a disc prolapse either if you lift a heavy weight, or you fall down, or something fell on your head, things like that. Or sometimes you won't even notice. You find a young boy coming to the clinic saying, I was lifting some weights in the gym and suddenly there was a catch. And then slowly, initially the pain is there in the back, and then it slowly starts radiating down because the nerves are getting compressed. So when we release this compression, the nerve compression reduces, and this radiating pain reduces, like for her. Like for her, the radiating pain reduced almost immediately. She underwent the procedure on Thursday and she is all right on Thursday. That's a nice question. Now, the disc need not be removed completely. We remove only part of the disc. We remove the protruding part of the disc so that the compression is relieved. If you relieve the complete disc, it will cause some amount of instability. You don't want that happening. You can do a part of the disc that is removed, and you can do it at maybe two levels at the same time. More than three would cause more instability. Two level disc removal through this technique is possible. See, there are what you can do is, if there are three bulges, my suggestion would be to think of surgery, or you have an option where you identify two bulges which are significant and then do a percutaneous discectomy in that. Through this technique, three levels, not a great idea, because it will cause some amount of instability. And another thing is, when you do an open surgery, other than the removal of the disc, they keep some rods and screws inside. Since we are not doing this from outside, so better to do it conservatively, and they produce excellent results similar to open surgery without the complications. This will cost, the equipment is made from US. At this point of time, Indians don't make this equipment. So importing this equipment is costly. The equipment alone would come to somewhere around $1,200. So that's about $60,000 for the equipment alone, because we are importing it from US. Surgery would be if you are using a stabilization wherein the rods are kept and screws are kept, somewhere around 1.5 to 2 lakhs. Totally, she has to spend around 60,000-70,000. As of now, there are pain clinics. There are about three pain clinics in Chennai at this point of time. So all of us do these procedures. We have started doing this percutaneous procedures for about 2 years now, and the results have been good. And this is the first time we have attempted in anybody above 90 kgs. She's about 130 kgs right now. So we've never done anything like this in somebody this big. And all the more relevant, because somebody this big is the one who will really benefit from it, because she's very prone for complications if she undergoes under general anesthesia. See, what we do is, after the procedure, we also put her on a rehabilitation program. The spine is not a single bone, it's multiple bones. They are all straight. Now, they are straight because there are surrounding ligaments and muscles supporting it. Now, if you can strengthen these surrounding muscles and ligaments, they continue to remain straight. So, the things that we caution people after any procedure, this is applicable to an interventional procedure like this or an open surgery, are they have to watch their back when they bend forward. They will not be able to go lift weights from now on, and they will not be able to, let's say, go in a two-wheeler or something like that. So she has to watch out for that. And we also put them on a series of exercises wherein her spine is strengthened so that she doesn't fall again, or it doesn't protrude again. Angola.
Regarding weight reduction, you said that she is being subject to physiotherapy and other forms of exercises. Any particular health treatment would you be administering?
See, there are the usual sequence that we think of is, first is we have to rehabilitate her and make her walk. Once you make her walk, the usual thing is we'll do the easy things first, that is general exercises, walking, treadmill, so on and so forth. She was able to walk yesterday. She had a walk for about 1 kilometer yesterday. She was fine with that. Now, once she is confident that her back is not going to hurt, she'll start walking, and then this will hasten her to do other exercises also. There is another extreme option wherein somebody who's much more bigger than this. She is 130 is okay. Sometimes, let's say somebody is coming with 150 and you feel they are orthopedically compromised and they have a problem. There is another option available called bariatric surgery. So that is a totally different, we are going totally off the line. That option is there. Apollo Hospitals does the surgery. There are about 3 or 4 hospitals in Chennai who do these surgeries. But first thing is, you should have tried easier things. Only if you failed, you should think of something like that. Not a great. Yes. So. No. At this point of time, we have cured her back. She will continue the exercises. She'll go back home and continue the exercises. If she doesn't reduce her weight with this, maybe we'll give her that option. Yeah. At this point, we're not thinking about it.
How long should she be here for the reorder?
She is planning to leave at the end of this month. But for all practical purposes, about 1 week in India should be enough. She'll have to follow up on the physiotherapy and these lifestyle changes that I talk about. Lifestyle changes in the sense, watch out for lifting weights, avoid these two-wheelers, bumpy rides and stuff. And always she has to, if let's say some patient, if something is lying down, if you and me can bend our back and lift it up, somebody like this, she has to bend her knees, sit, take the weight, straighten the knees. So instead of putting strain on the back, we encourage patients to put strain on the knees. So lifestyle changes like that. She has been having this problem for about 3 years now. She was struggling. Not she is not bedridden, but she had a severe back pain. Yesterday? When was it that she last walked 1 kilometer? You ask her and tell her. About near before. This the last time she walked 1 kilometer was about 1 year ago. Yeah, it progressively got worse. Have you want to say specific about the treatment and we are happy to. He will translate it for you, she will answer it. Yeah?